Hi, my name is Avtar Monga. I'm one of your alumni. Here I am today to tell you about my life's experiences and journey. And I really want to talk about not just what I did in the corporate office, but also how I went about learning it. So just to start, I want to share with you that when I joined BIMTech, that was more than two decades ago, the way BIMTech was different, the environment was different, and even in my own case, unlike most of you who are actually starting your career in terms of the education side, I'd actually already worked for more than 15 years in Bank of America. So when I joined BIMTech, it used to be not in this campus where we are, which is so beautiful, but actually in a school in Saket. And if I look at it from the standpoint of where it's come today, it's a very long journey. So when I joined BIMTech, I actually was looking to get further understanding of the business by formally actually going through an education process. After having worked for 15, 16 years in a foreign bank, I felt that though I knew enough about business, I still needed to get some additional skills and get it in a structured manner, which allows me to actually enhance my career aspiration and the success factor by a huge margin. As luck would have it, I used to work for GE Capital in those days, and I used to come for the classes while actually being part of a big business. And I want to share something very interesting with you. In my second year, if I remember right, I was actually promoted to be a CEO of the company I was to be part of. And then I had to keep a very low profile so that people don't start to treat me very differently. But I really enjoyed the time I spent there. And I've actually continued to be in touch with both the faculty, particularly Director Sir, and also a lot of people I met during my time there. And some of us are very, very close friends. So let me talk about what I did post that. So after I finished my stint with GE Capital, where I used to be running their credit card company, which is SBI Cards, in the, there are two companies there, I used to be heading one of them. I even went to run the truck financing company for GE Capital. And then after that, in 2003, if I remember right, I was called back by Bank of America to set up what is called the back office. And actually it was a startup again because it was beginning of a new company. And then over the next 10 years, it became from a very small, humble beginning in Hyderabad to actually being a company which had a global presence. It's called BA Continuum today. And in that entire journey of 10 years, one had to go through a lot of implementation of what you learned in the courses. They teach you things like, this is the way the organization works, this is how the people behave, this is how the financial system works. All of them are very important learnings, because as you build a business, as you scale a business, as you deal with a large number of people, especially multiple nationalities, multiple currencies, multiple regulators, multiple customer expectations, it does really help you to understand what you learned in the college, both at the graduation and the post-graduation level. So many times when I was actually looking for a solution in my, those working days at Bank of America, I would actually even call some friends, talk to them, and the friends were made at BIMTech and otherwise, and also speak to some of the faculty members once in a while. So it really, really helps. And in those 10 years, I can tell you one thing, they were the most rewarding years, because I was able to implement a lot of learning and actually scale the business from nothing to almost 30,000 plus people and in more than six countries. And the other thing I did was I also wanted to continuously keep learning myself, because I firmly believe that learning never stops. You learn from each other, you learn from the environment, you learn from the regulation change. You also mature as an individual. It's not that just the books teach you. It is also the daily life which teaches you. And all of this continues, and this is a never-ending process. So after having worked in a very global environment and having worked with a lot of good people, it was in 2013 that I wanted to actually start doing something very different. And the idea was that I wanted to work for a company which is going to be in India, because I originally used to believe that ultimately I'm going to settle here and not move overseas. And as a result, I some domestic opportunities, and over a period of 7-8 months, we were able to shorten the list, and finally I chose to become part of what is called IDFC. Now, this was a company which was set up by, actually out of a budget speech, because there was a need at that time to create a very focused entity which is dedicated to actually financing infrastructure. And that's the origin of IDFC. But then over the years, the success bred, more and more new businesses being brought in, and it became a company which had a wide-ranging businesses. But when I joined, my intent and the desire and the mandate was very different. By then, they had become a very successful entity, and they were aspiring to be a bank, but not a regular bank, but bank with a very futuristic view. And the futuristic, both from the standpoint of how they operate, but also not only that, also the client segments they serve. So mostly people used to believe in those days that the banks are largely focused on large cities and big clients with big deep pockets. IDFC wanted to create a model where we were able to actually cater to all customer stratas, right from the poorest of the poor, unbanked of the unbanked, rural, remotest village of the country, as well as the corporate customers who are dealing with large money. So it was a great opportunity to actually apply all my life's learning. And I joined them in 2014 and actually 14. And we started with the agenda to build a very different bank. And the different is like everybody says we are different. But the intent was to use technology and make the banking so reliable and cheap, so that the customers don't need to worry about the cost of doing banking. So as a result, we actually spent a fair amount of time looking at what's available, and we went looking for how to service all those customers which cannot pay you large fee structures. So we developed what is now called Bank in a Box, a small micro ATM machine, which is nothing but a bank you can carry in your bag because it's Wi-Fi connected. And you can go to any part of India and conduct almost all banking transactions, whether it's foreign exchange, it's the paying of the premium or cash withdrawal, deposit and savings and all that. So we did that. And then parallelly, we also looked at how we can really make it a digital play. So a lot of things were done right from, starting from the technology being leveraged to make self-banking, you could do everything yourself. The account opening was automated. You don't have to go to a bank and you can open an account. With Aadhaar card, they could actually do almost everything. And then we also participated in building the national infrastructure, because there was a time when India Spirit program was being led by Nandan and team, and they were looking to do stuff which will make everybody have access to the financial system. So we also then related with them very well, and we identified a lot of fintechs and started to find a way to work with them, because mostly what happens in the fintech space is that they have the idea, they have the technology, but they need to get a client base or a testing platform where they can really understand and test their products they are configuring. So we actually worked with many startups in the initial phase, and some of them today are actually unicorns. They are worth billions of dollars, and those are success stories. And during that period, I also felt that maybe now it's time has come for me to think about what else. So sometime in last year, I actually decided to come out of, I even was on the board of the bank for a while. I came out of IDFC Group, and this is post the merger, and then started thinking about the next thing. So after looking at, what I had done in the bank, I felt that there was a possibility that I could work more directly with the startups. And I know BIMTech is very closely involved with the Atal Innovation Mission. I have actually had an opportunity to come and speak to some of the startups and Uttaransh. And I do believe that the institution is doing a lot of good work in promoting what the PM now calls Atmanirbhar Bharat. So I think all this is happening at the right level, and this is going to keep going. So the more recent thing is, we actually then decided to participate with a couple of other colleagues from IDFC and form a company which is nothing but a venture debt firm, which is an AIF. And the idea is to actually create a platform which allows the well-run startups which have gone past the initial phases to really get a support in terms of working capital so that they can elongate their need. By virtue of that, they actually reduce their dilution process a little bit. We've been at it for now 7-8 months, and the intent is that we actually help these startups and not just give them money but also work with them very closely, because many times I see what I used to see in BIMTech when I was starting, that we knew lot of things theoretically, we didn't know practically, and in many cases we knew things practically, did not know the real science behind it. So when you combine the learning with the experience, it becomes a more powerful game. And as you will learn over the next couple of years being at BIMTech, that a lot of learning today needs practical input, and that's what this institution is all about. So in the current setup also, we not just give the money, we actually involve ourselves in helping the company. We actually work with the promoter founders to figure out how they're going to do things, what is the best way to get them support and all that. So all that is happening. And interestingly, while we all are facing what we are facing these days called COVID and all that, this is also an interesting change because it has actually brought some new things to the table. I mean, last year, if you were to ask somebody, if I don't go to office for 5 months, will I still be there? Answer would have been no. But today, the fact is nobody goes to office. The other thing is learning patterns have changed. You know, digital was a small component of our lives. Digital is almost a full 100% story today. It has also taught a lot of human lessons. You know, if you ask me, it has been a leveler, because what used to happen is that people were actually distinguished by, you know, how big the car is and how big the house is. Today, the fact is if you have 5 cars, you can drive nothing. So there is no real value of five big cars. So it has actually created an environment where people have started to think of things very differently. Things which used to be mattering the most don't matter that much. The simplest things like keeping healthy is the most important agenda. People used to think of business model in a very different way. Today the business models are largely digital, tech oriented, and a remote managed processes. Going forward, I see this journey is going to continue. Some of this might reverse because human habits are, you know, hard to change, but a large portion of what is happening today will continue in future. So all of you need to really think about, how will you do business when you go out of BIMTech after passing out? And what is it that you can learn from today's environment, which will go hand in hand with your teaching and learning to make you a very successful either entrepreneur or an employee of a large institution? I have had a great opportunity. In both my organizations, I have had the opportunity to actually come for recruiting to BIMTech, this thing. And I have seen the quality of talent, and the people who come out of our institution are absolutely the class. I still remember my batchmates. Some of them still work for Bank of America, some work for ICICI, some for GE Capital, all those. So I still remember and keep in touch with them. So one of the things I wanted to leave with you out of my today's interaction, and I'm really thankful for the opportunity, is that we need to start thinking about how the world is going to change and what are the new things we need to be very careful and knowledgeable about. Of course, we'll compete. We are in this world, we will be very competitive. We will go into different jobs, we will fight with each other, and we'll also be successful, and some of us will learn through the process. But one of the things you need to understand is that the recent environment has changed a few things. One is that there is a belief now that we all are in this together. There's no separate treatment to a rich versus poor as far as COVID is concerned. So it has leveled all different things. So it has brought about the something which you are starting to forget, you know, the compassion, the humility. The other thing which we need to also remember is that I think ultimately relationships go a very long way in all situations, whether they are good, bad, when you're doing very well, and particularly when you're not doing well. So focus on relationships. Understand that every human has a need. It's the timing which is the variable. Today's time has taught us that we are all in this together. And the good news is, like many other things, this shall too pass. And I'm sure as a country, I'm actually involved in a few things. The way we are looking at Atmanirbhar Bharat, I'm very sure, combined with the Atal Innovation Mission and other things, after the initial hiccup, which will be a couple of quarters from now for sure, we will emerge as a very strong economy. And I do believe that all of you have a very robust future as you step out of your learning days. And I'm sure you all will remember each of the days you're spending at BIMTECH and will continue to be in touch with each other, not just when you're at the college, but also post that. And actually make this institution, which I have seen actually in the last 20 years, emerge from being a very small setup in South Delhi to now having campus, which is in a very large space in Greater Noida, plus now we have the Orissa. And I'm very pleased to share with you that even my son is an alumni of this, you know, institution. And so I truly believe in that, and I really want to acknowledge the entire faculty, particularly Director Sir, Gagan Sir, and the ma'ams, and all of the colleagues I met those days. And it's a wonderful journey. So I really want to thank you for this time, and hopefully I was able to share part of my life with you. And I'm on LinkedIn. Anytime you need anything, just, you know, connect with me, and I'll be talking to you one-on-one. Thank you very much.